Day 14, Captain's Log. What's the question?
Paul, tell us how your vision's coming together so far on this film.
My vision? Well, it's not my vision. It's Dominique and my vision. In fact, it's probably more Dominique than mine. This whole film is based on his experiences growing up with the police. You know, at the end of the film, he's the black guy in Driving While Black. And it's very important to me that he gets the proper credit. It's a true collaboration, and it wouldn't happen without him. So it's really our vision. And you know, you'd have to ask him how he's feeling, but I think it's the same as me. We're stoked with the way this is going. Yeah, it's funny as fuck. And it's dark and real, too. You know, I don't think there's been a film like this, so we're very excited. The footage is looking great. Brian, the DP, is doing a great job, and I think it's going to be the best film that I ever made, that's for sure.
And so, just being on set on a daily basis, I can see how much more involved Dom is than your average co-writer. So, can you give us a few examples of some of the things that he's helped in terms of direction?
Well, he makes it a lot less cheesy. Whenever I want to plan out a scene, I'm taking it in that more sort of Hollywood, you know, what's going to make a really fun scene direction. But he keeps it real, you know, because he was there. These things happened to him. So I know that everything that, if I just follow what he says, it's going to work out and it's going to be real. And this film lives or dies on its authenticity, and that's something that's been very important to us throughout.
And how can you turn what many people believe to be such a heavy subject into a comedy?
Well, you can turn anything into a comedy. I'm a big fan of rape jokes. Child molestation, fuck it. You know, it's all funny. In fact, you know, the more serious it is, the funnier it can be, really. You know, we've seen movies like Fruitvale. You know, I loved it. Great movie. But I don't, you know, I want to sit through that. And it's not that I don't want to sit through it. It's a great film, but I don't want to. It doesn't put me in a good mood. It puts me in a bad mood. This is a fun one that afterwards you'll feel like you had a great time. And also, you know, walk away with enlightened, you know, the horizons broadened, if you will.
Is there anything specific that you hope this film achieves?
Well, if it makes me some cash.
Besides that? Socially?
Yeah, you know, that would be nice. It would be nice if... Yeah, you know, what do I want to say here? It would be nice if people were a little bit more aware of the African-Americans' plight while driving around. The police smartened up a bit. You know, that would be nice. But really, I guess we're just trying to raise some awareness.
And
let have people have a good time. You know, do it in a fun way.
Do you have any anticipation on how police officers may react when watching this film?
I hope they like it. We tried to make it balanced. I mean, there's a lot of cop input in this film. And I hope they see it as fair and balanced. The hero is a cop, you know, the villain's a cop too, but it's not a one-sided, we hate the police, fuck the police kind of deal. You know, that's kind of boring. It's not really that interesting, I think. So we're trying to make it, you know, give it some texture, some context.
And speaking of how audiences may react, do you have any anticipation on how black audiences may react versus white audiences?
Well, I think they'll relate a little bit more. I hope so. White audiences, you know, everybody likes to laugh, you know. Maybe white power groups wouldn't like it so much. I don't know. Me and Dom will have to go and test that out.
And artistically, what makes this film different from your last couple of films?
I think it's a heavier subject. My last movie's about, you know, partying, drugs, sex, fucking whatever, you know. This is about something a little bit more serious.